Hi, my name is Lindsey Olivares, and I am the production designer and lead character designer on The Mitchells vs. the Machines, and I'm going to show you how to draw Katie. So, Katie Mitchell. Usually when I start drawing Katie, I'll start with her glasses. It's kind of like a rounded square shape frame for her. Her nose is a little simple shape that kind of breaks that glasses shape. Then I'll come in here and fill in her glasses. For her eyes, they can be kind of irregular. Sometimes we'll play with one being a little bit bigger than the other. She's got kind of small pupils. And again, having a little bit of irregularity in the shape helps. They clean that up a little bit. The characters often have these little lines around their eyes too. Give her little simple eyebrow shapes. Katie has kind of messy hair, so she's got a couple simple pieces at the top of the head breaking out. And this kind of bigger bang at the side, it's got kind of three distinct kind of triangle shapes. She's got a big kind of personality, somewhat big mouth. She has a little lightning bolt earring, little ponytail, and like little loose hair. For a lot of the look of the world, we really kept some of the signs that it had been drawn. So they're not super perfect. They have a little bit of irregularity to them, like you drew them. I hope that the film resonates in a way that people kind of appreciate their imperfect selves, imperfect family. As a core theme is something that I hope a lot of people take away from it. You know, there's kind of a simple message that you don't have to be like a perfect family. With Katie, we tried a lot of different designs for her. In some versions, we leaned into her maybe looking more like Rick, her father, so it feels more like they're the same but opposite. I think she contrasts from Rick, but also has a little bit of like a related quality that they all feel like Mitchells. She took the longest to find and design. I think it's always hard to get your main character right, but that was really fun to explore and to find her personality, find ways to kind of push her that she can feel like an artist and a filmmaker. I was always kind of imagining her like touching her hair while she's thinking, and it has a little bit of a creative chaos to it. I would say I identify with Katie the most. I think there's kind of an artistic, creative energy that's there that I feel like I identified with on the project. So that was really fun to figure her out and to think about her character. I guess color gives us just another way to tell us something a little bit more about the character. A color that we used a lot for Katie is red. It's like the color of her hoodie. I think red naturally has like a boldness to it, which feels right for her character. But we kind of talked about like her hair being more dyed red, you know, than the natural red. We tried to make it seem like her roots were more brown, like maybe they're more like the color of, you know, her dad's hair or something, but she's trying to be her own person, be a little bit different. And so it's just another way to, you know, tell the audience more about our characters. And then her shirt, it's supposed to be like a little weird pinky yellow multi-eyed munchy creature on her shirt. There you have it. Now you know how to draw Katie Mitchell. Thanks for watching.